اللهم صل على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And I close my eyes and I'm floating alive. And I close my eyes and I'm running alive. And I close my eyes. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد, it gives me great pleasure to welcome you to a series of talks that we're going to do about the Sirat al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the life and biography of the beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the lessons and morals that we can extract from that biography. I am your host, Yasir Qadhi. So the topic of these series of episodes will center around the biography of the greatest human being ever created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the final prophet and the most perfect messenger ever sent to mankind, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When we start talking about a personality, the first thing that we mention are the names that this personality had. And our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had many names. And this is an indication of the numerous qualities that he was blessed with. For the Arabs of old would enumerate the blessings and the special qualities of any object by giving it many, many names. Hence, for the Arabs, the more names that a being had, the more blessed and the more important that being was. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was blessed with many, many names. And of course, the most important and the most central of his names was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that he was given many other names by Allah ta'ala himself. In one hadith in Sahih Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam enumerated some of these names. He said in an authentic hadith, Ana Muhammad, I am Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa ana Ahmad, and I am also Ahmad. So of his names is Ahmad. The third name he said, and I am Al-Mahi. I am Al-Mahi, and we will explain the meanings of all of these names. He said, I am also Al-Aqib. So Al-Mahi and Al-Aqib, 3 and 4. Yet another name, he said, he is Al-Aqib, which means that there is no prophet going to come after him. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam enumerated in this hadith a number of very central names. The first of them, he said, is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The second is Ahmad. These two are the most important and the most central of his names. And it is amazing they both come from the same root, which is Hamida. Hamida means to praise. So Muhammad and Ahmad are two names that come from the same root word, which means to praise. Muhammad means the praised one, the praiseworthy. And Ahmad also means the praised one or the praiseworthy. But there is a very big difference between Muhammad and Ahmad. Muhammad means the praised one, that he will be praised because of the qualities that are present in him. So people will praise him because of the qualities that are present in him. Qualities such as honesty, truthfulness, humility, humbleness. Qualities that all of mankind acknowledges to be praiseworthy and worthy of hamd. Muhammad signifies that he shall be praised by many, many people. Continuously. Muhammad signifies quantity, that there will be millions and billions of people who will praise him, and they will continue to do so time in and time out. Ahmad signifies that he is praised for the most noble qualities, in the most noble manners of being praised. So Ahmad signifies the quality, and Muhammad signifies the quantity. Muhammad and Ahmad. Muhammad means he is going to be praised quantity-wise. Millions and billions of people are going to praise him and send their salutations and peace and blessings upon him. From the time of his coming, even before his coming, he was praised. Allah and the angels praised him, and the previous prophets praised him. And after his coming, he shall also be praised. And if you look at the quantity of praise that our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is continuously given, never is his name mentioned anywhere on earth except that we add sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah Azza wa Jal exalt him and raise his status and send his blessings upon him. Never is Allah's name mentioned except that right after it, typically we mention the name of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As Allah says in the Quran, وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. We have raised up your remembrance. In other words, people remember you, people will know you, and there is hardly a human being except that he is aware of the name of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So Muhammad is for quantity, as we said, and there is no greater indication of this quantity than the fact that on the day of judgment, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resurrects all of mankind, the Muslims and the non-Muslims, the believers and the disbelievers, every single human being shall petition, shall beg, shall plead our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam to intercede for them in front of Allah. And this intercession is called the Maqam al-Mahmood, the praiseworthy station. It is a station, a status that is praiseworthy. Why is it praiseworthy? Because every single atom of creation, every single living soul shall praise the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam on that day. It is the Maqam al-Mahmood given to Muhammad and Ahmad. It is the praiseworthy station given to the one who is worthy of all types of praise that man gives to men. And also he is worthy of the choicest and the most blessed and the most magnificent of all praises that man can give to men. So Muhammad is for quantity. Every single human being shall praise the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If not in this world, if they disbelieve in him, then at least in the hereafter, at least on the day of judgment, every human being shall praise him. And we will talk about this Maqam al-Mahmood in a little while, inshaAllah ta'ala. And the second name we said is Ahmad. And Ahmad means the best praises, the choicest praises, the most magnificent praises that a man can give to another man. It is not possible to praise a human being more than to praise the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Hence, he is Muhammad and he is also Ahmad. And these two are his most common and his most comprehensive of names. Another name that we mentioned, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, وَأَنَا الْمَاحِي. I am the Mahi. Al-Mahi is the one who wipes away, who erases. This is what Al-Mahi means. What did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam erase? He erased disbelief in Allah. He erased polytheism from Arabia. Arabia was a polytheistic society. But with the coming of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he managed to completely erase the concept of polytheism in Arabia. And we were now talking about Al-Mahi. And we said Al-Mahi means the eraser or the effacer, the one who wipes away. And what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did, which is why he is called the eraser, was that he erased shirk, or the worship of other than Allah, i.e. polytheism, idolatry, from the Arabian Peninsula. Arabia was a land immersed in idolatry. People used to worship everything and anything. They used to worship rocks and stones and trees. They used to worship carved out images, as is present in many countries, unfortunately, to this day. But with the coming of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, idolatry was eliminated in most of the world. It used to be idolatrous. Now there are only a few pockets here and there that are predominantly idolatrous. And this was with the coming of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And eventually a time shall come towards the end of times, we believe, where all of humanity will accept the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as a prophet of Allah, where every single human being on earth will indeed be a Muslim and a worshipper of Allah. Hence, eventually, the message of our beloved Prophet ﷺ will prevail, and he shall wipe out all disbelief from the face of this earth. And that is why he has been called Al-Mahi. Another name that Allah Azza wa Jal gave to our beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was Al-Hashir. And Al-Hashir means the one after whom everybody else is resurrected. In other words, the first being to be resurrected as a precursor, as the first person who shall then initiate the rest of the resurrection by the blessings of Allah, meaning that Allah will resurrect our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and then he shall resurrect everybody else. And this is the meaning of Al-Hashir, that the first being to be resurrected shall be our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and that shall be on the Day of Judgment. Yet another name of our beloved Rasul is Al-Aqib. العاقب. The Prophet said, وَأَنَا الْحَاشِرُ وَأَنَا الْعَاقِبُ. I am the hashir, I am the عاقب. The عاقب means that he is the final. He is the seal. He shall shut the door for all any future prophets to come. We need to take a short break now. Stay with us and we'll continue talking about the characteristics and specialities of our beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. See you in a second. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Assalamu alaykum. Welcome back. We were discussing the names of our beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we had discussed the names Muhammad and Ahmad, and we were now talking about Al-Mahi. And we said Al-Mahi means the eraser or the effacer, the one who wipes away. And what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did, which is why he is called the eraser, was that he erased shirk, or the worship of other than Allah, i.e. polytheism, idolatry, from the Arabian Peninsula. Arabia was a land immersed in idolatry. People used to worship everything and anything. They used to worship rocks and stones and trees. They used to worship carved out images, as is present in many countries, unfortunately, to this day. But with the coming of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, idolatry was eliminated in most of the world. It used to be idolatrous. Now there are only a few pockets here and there that are predominantly idolatrous. And this was with the coming of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And eventually a time shall come towards the end of times, we believe, where all of humanity will accept the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as a prophet of Allah, where every single human being on earth will indeed be a Muslim and a worshipper of Allah. Hence, eventually, the message of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will prevail, and he shall wipe out all disbelief from the face of this earth. And that is why he has been called Al-Mahi. Another name that Allah Azza wa Jal gave to our beloved Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam was Al-Hashir. And Al-Hashir means the one after whom everybody else is resurrected. In other words, the first being to be resurrected as a precursor, as the first person who shall then initiate the rest of the resurrection by the blessings of Allah, meaning that Allah will resurrect our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and then he shall resurrect everybody else. And this is the meaning of Al-Hashir, that the first being to be resurrected shall be our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and that shall be on the Day of Judgment. Yet another name of our beloved Rasul is Al-Aqib. Al-Aqib. The Prophet said, وَأَنَا الْحَاشِرُ وَأَنَا الْعَاقِبُ. I am the hashir, I am the عَاقِبُ. The عَاقِبُ means that he is the final. He is the seal. He shall shut the door for all any future prophets to come. So the عَاقِبُ means the seal. That the Prophet said, لَيْسَ بَعْدِي نَبِي. There shall not be a prophet that shall come after me. So because he is the seal of the Prophet, he has been called الْعَاقِبُ, meaning the door has been shut. Prophecy has ceased to exist. There shall no longer be future prophets and messengers. The final prophet and messenger is our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hence his name is Al-Aqib. In another hadith in At-Tirmidhi, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ana nabiyyur rahma wa ana nabiyyut tawbah. So he gave two more names. He said, I am the prophet of mercy and I am the prophet of repentance. The prophet of mercy and the Prophet of Repentance. So two more titles, two more names that our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has been given by Allah. He is the Prophet of Mercy. Meaning, as Allah says in the Quran, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have only sent you to be a mercy for all of mankind. The coming of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the message of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the character and lifestyle of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, belief in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all of it is but a mercy to imitate him, to believe in him, to take him as a role model. Every single facet of his lifestyle is a mercy for all of mankind. Those who believe in him and even those who don't believe in him, if they follow his teachings, they shall find mercy in that. So he is the Nabiyyur Rahmah, that Allah sent him as a manifestation of Allah's mercy. Because Allah cared about us, because he wanted the best for us, he chose for us this Nabiyyur Rahmah, and he sent us the Nabiyyur Rahmah. He sent us the Prophet of Mercy in order that we believe in him, that we study his teachings, that we benefit from him. So he is the Nabiyyur Rahmah. He also said he is the Nabiyyut Tawbah. Nabiyyut Tawbah is the Prophet of Repentance, meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not want to destroy mankind. He doesn't want to punish people. He wants people to come to him and repent to him. Allah wants mankind to believe in him. And as a manifestation of that mercy and repentance, he has sent the Prophet of Mercy. Here is your chance. This is your opportunity. Study this man's teachings. Look at his biography. Take heed of what he has come with. And when you believe in him, and if you have a clean heart, you shall believe in him. It is not possible that you have a pure and clean heart and you study the teachings of this man and yet you still reject him. It is not humanly possible, because this man is the Prophet of Allah. Everything about him says it. From his character and his names and his lifestyle and his teachings, everything shouts out, I am the Prophet of Mercy. I am the Prophet of Repentance. So believing in the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and affirming his prophethood and taking him as a role model, this is our only chance of salvation. We have no other way of attaining Allah's forgiveness and Allah's mercy except by worshipping Allah based upon the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah. So his name is also Nabiyut Tawbah. And there are many, many more names as well. And I want to point out here that many times you will find books that mention dozens and hundreds of names of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Most of these names, they have been given by the scholars of Islam. Some of them the Sahaba and Tabi'un. Many others were invented by later scholars. Hence, we need to be careful and make sure that the meanings of these names are correct. We have to ascertain and verify the meanings of these names are correct. Indeed, the Prophet ﷺ gave us many names. These are some of them that I quoted you today. But other names that are found, that are commonly found in plaques, in posters, in books, these are names that the scholars have given, and there is no problem in that as long as the name has a legitimate meaning. But if we take it to a higher level and we give him aspects of divinity, you see there's a big difference between Muslims and Christians, right? Christians took their prophet and they made him into a god or a son of God. They made their prophet a human being, no doubt a miraculous birth, no doubt a blessed human being, but nonetheless a human being. He used to eat and drink, and he was born of a woman, even though he was born without a father. Yet he was born of a woman, and he lived a normal life as a child, and he grew up as a human being and an adult. They took this human being, and they converted him into a divine image, a divine icon. They gave him characteristics of divinity, and they called him God, or the Son of God, or a part of a trinity. Whereas the Muslims, they said, no. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is indeed the best human being, along with the other prophets. And we affirm their superior characteristics, and we affirm they are the best of the best, but we do not give them aspects of divinity. They are not God, they are not divine, they are the best human beings. So some people, unfortunately, in their love, they go a little bit beyond bounds, and they ascribe to the Prophet ﷺ things that should not be ascribed to him. The point being, we have to be careful that the names that we read of the Prophet ﷺ are authentic and divine names. As we said, the most important names that the Prophet ﷺ himself said are Muhammad and Ahmed and Aqib and also Al-Mahi and also Al-Hashir and Nabiyur Rahmah and Nabiyur Tawbah. And he mentioned a few more names as well, but these are the primary names that are mentioned in the Seerah and in the books of the Sunnah. After we mention a person's names, the next thing that we talk about, what is so special about him? This is how we generally introduce people. We introduce their name, and then why is he so famous? Why is he so important? So for the remainder of this session, and also in our part two of this series, we will talk about the special characteristics of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What makes him so special? What was he given that nobody else was given? Unique. Only to this human being. What was this particular human being given that all other humanity, every other human being was deprived of? There are many, many, many things. And really we cannot do justice to the specialities of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but we will try to mention maybe 10, 15 of them to give us some basic indication of who this man was. The first and the most obvious blessing that he was given, that no other human being was given, was that he was made the seal of the prophets. There were many prophets before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. According to one hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent 124,000 prophets. And he sent around 315, roughly 315 messengers. 124,000 anbiya, nabi, and 315 roughly rasul or rusul. So there were many prophets and messengers whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent. What makes our Prophet ﷺ special from all of them? Many things. One of them, and the most obvious as we said, is the fact that he is the seal, the final. This long link of 315, this long chain of 124,000, the final brick, the final link, the seal of this long chain ends with our beloved Rasul, Muhammad ibn Abdullah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us, and Allah has told us. Allah says in the Quran, مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَى أَحَدٍ مِّن رِجَالِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad, Allah says in the Quran, he calls him by name Muhammad. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not the father of any of your men. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not leave behind male heirs. There were no sons that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left after his death who grew up and became adults. So Allah told us there are no sons that he has fathered in the sense that who lived after him. But what is special about him? He is the Rasul of Allah and the Khatam, the seal of the prophets. And this verse is also recited in other recitations of the Quran, Khatim, meaning the end. So he is the end and he is the seal. The seal, do you know what a seal is? A seal, in the old days, they would have, this important people wear a ring. They would wear a ring with their signature on it. And when they would finish writing a letter to indicate that they had wrote the letter, they would wrap the paper up and they would put wax on the seal and then seal that paper. Nobody could open the paper without breaking the seal and the wax. So this was their signature, that this is the final stamp of authority. Allah says this man, Muhammad SAW, is the Khatam. He is that stamp, the final stamp. Nobody can break it now. Nobody can open the chain of prophets after him. In the other recitation, وَخَاتِمُ النَّبِيِّينَ, he is the end and the final of all prophets. And there's no contradiction because the final is also the seal. And the Prophet ﷺ said in an authentic hadith, وَلَيْسَ بَعْدِي نَبِيٍّ, there shall come no prophet after me. Hence, any person who claims to be a prophet or to believe in a prophet after the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ is simply not a Muslim. He may call himself what he may. He will not qualify as being a Muslim because a Muslim must believe in Allah as his creator and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as his worshipper and prophet and final messenger. So this was one of the specialities that he was given. So far in this episode, we have discussed some of the names of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we've also discussed some of his characteristics. In the future episodes, we will continue talking about the characteristics of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his mannerisms and morals. And then we will start talking about the beloved life, the birth, the upbringing, the childhood, the marriage, and then the prophecy, and then his stages in Mecca and Medina until the ultimate death of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All of these shall be the topic of our series of episodes entitled Sirat al-Rasul, Lessons and Morals. Therefore, I hope that inshallah ta'ala, you will join me in our next episode as we continue talking about the beloved seerah, the beloved biography of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Until next time, I hope to see you then. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ya Rabb al-Alami, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I close my eyes.